In this video, we are going to discuss about compensators. Generally, compensators are used to get the required performance specifications. For example, if you want to stabilize the unstable system, you can use compensators. That means, as the name indicates, how much compensation is required to get your performance specifications, to get your required performance specification, that much amount can be given by this compensators. So here you can see compensators are used to obtain the desired performance specifications. So as we already discussed about stability analysis, if you want stability of the system, if your desired performance specification is stability, then to stabilize the unstable systems, compensators are greatly used. So now, how in a control system we are going to use this compensators, where we are going to use this compensators. So for example, if this is a control system, you forgot about this, you are having a forward loop gain and a feedback. Now here I am adding a compensator in cascade to the regular gain. So now this is cascade compensator. Similarly, so here where GC of S is equivalent to compensator. For example, without this compensator, if that network is unstable network, if you want to make that control system as stable, then you need to maintain a compensator there. So here I am having another structure of compensator. That means how we can use compensator in a control system. Here I can use it as a feedback network. So here you can see GC of S, that means compensator is in feedback with regular gain. So this is called as feedback compensation. So this is feedback compensation network, this is cascade compensation network. So whenever your compensator is in cascade with your regular gain, then that is called as cascade compensator or general compensator. Whenever you are having your regular gain with feedback with this cascade or feedback with compensator, then we can say this is feedback compensator. So this total network is in feedback compensation. So now coming to this diagram, this combined cascade and feedback compensation. So here we are using two compensator, one in cascade network, one in feedback network. So this total control system is called as combined cascade and feedback compensation control system. So now this is about compensators. Generally, compensators are used to get our desired performance specifications. So in control system, especially the system stability is our performance specification, that means required performance specification. So to stabilize the system, we are going to use these compensators. And how we can use a compensator in a control system means we are having three ways. So we can use in cascade, or we can use in feedback, and we can use either in cascade, both in cascade and feedback. Coming to compensators, types of compensators, we are having four types of compensators. So greatly used compensators are three only. So here these are the four compensators we are having. So lead compensator, lag lead compensator, lead lag compensator. So these four are the compensators we are having, but greatly used compensators are only these three. So that means lead compensator and lag lead compensator are greatly used compensators in control system. So in next classes, we are going to discuss each compensator with effects and analysis. So this is about the introduction of compensators.